One of the useful tools when you want to take a column like this and split it so that certain components are in their own column is under data. It's the text to columns tool. So we're going to show you a few times how it works and tell you some of the special aspects of it. So the first thing we're going to do here, we're going to highlight this. We can see that there seems to be a dash between the numbers, which indicates what should be in which column. If I highlight it, I push text to columns, this pops up. We've got a choice of delimited or fixed width. Delimited means it's separated by something, a character of some sorts, in this case a dash. If I say next, I'm going to say it's not a tab, it's something other. I'm going to put a dash in there. You'll see immediately it looks like it's getting it right. Always useful to come down here, just check that's making sense. If I say next, this screen then allows me to specify what type of data you've got, or if you do not want to import something. For now, we're going to just accept it as is. When I say finish, you'll see it immediately puts them into separate columns. I'm just going to undo it. If we again highlight the same thing, text to columns, this time we're going to use fixed width. In this case, it's possible. When I say next, you'll see Excel now wants to know what you want to separate. And I can click. So I'm going to click there, 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 and there. What I'm telling Excel is I want that column. I want the dash in its own column, the number, dash in its own column, the number. When I say next, you'll see, again, it's asked me for that. And this time, I'm going to click on that column. You'll see it's highlighted. And I'm going to say do not import. Click on that one, do not import. When I say finish, notice that it's done the exact same thing, but it hasn't imported the dashes. You will notice, however, I'm just going to undo here, or just notice this first. Notice that that says 1, 2. When I undo, notice what it actually said was 0, 0, 1. If we are happy that the 001 turns to a 1, then that's fine. But a little bit later, I'm going to show you how we can address that as well. Just to show you, this one was pretty much standard. You can see it's 3 characters, then a dash, 5 characters, then a dash. This tool is also useful where you've got situations like this. And what we've got is a product description, and it looks like the hashes are separating the columns. But you can see they're all different lengths. So again, we can highlight it. We go text to columns. It's definitely delimited. So I'm going to go next. And I'm going to say other. I'm going to change that to a hash. Immediately, you'll see it looks like it's correct. Always useful to go down here. If I'm happy with that, I can go next. I can change the formatting if I want. When I say finish, you'll see it perfectly gets the information. Now I'm just going to show you a little bit more about the issue with numbers. So what you'll notice here is I've got the branch and bank number, and they're right next to each other, split by a space. What's important about this bank number is firstly it starts with a 0, and you'll notice it's very long. So if we did the normal text to column, I can either use delimited or fixed width. So I'm going to stay with delimited. I'm going to switch it off and say it's a space. So all of that looks fine. If I stop there, you'll see it gets that right. But notice these numbers look a bit strange. And if I format them as a long number, you'll notice that firstly it doesn't start with a 0, so this is what it should be. Can you see it's starting with a 0? And because it's such a long number, notice that this number ends with 119, this one ends with 110, that ends with 636, that ends with 630. Excel cannot handle extremely long numbers. Eventually it gets to a point where it rounds it. So let's just undo. So when we have got this position, same thing, we go text to columns, going to delimit it, we're going to say it's a space, that's fine. But when we say next, we have to be very careful. We've got to tell it that this over here is text. So what we're telling Excel is ignore the fact that it looks like a number. Whatever's written here, we want to see. When I say finish, you'll notice now that it pulls through exactly the numbers as shown, therefore the correct bank number.